Two other news tonight. Donald Trump's plans to return to the White House have hit a snag after he was disqualified from the Republican primary ballot in the state of Colorado by the state Supreme Court. That effectively rules him out of the presidential race there due to his role in the January 6 riots. The court voted 4-3 to remove him under the US Constitution's so-called insurrection clause. The decision, though, is on hold pending appeal. At a rally in Iowa, Trump appeared to acknowledge the development.
Our enemies want to take away my freedom because I will never let them take away your freedom. It's very simple. I'm not going to let them do it. They want to silence me because I will never let them silence you. And in the end, they're not after me. They're after you. I just happen to be standing in their way, and I always will stand in their way.
Well, having taken an oath to speak with us tonight, Steve Clemons is here to tell us the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth, Steve. Colorado's a state that's likely to vote Democrat anyway.
Donald Trump is the gift that keeps on giving.
Colorado likely would vote Democrat anyway. So just explain what this all means for us, like we're not Americans.
Well, look, I mean, it's the first time that a Supreme Court in any state has determined that Donald Trump was an insurrectionist. And under our Constitution, in Article 14, Section 3, it says if you're an insurrectionist, if you basically try to overthrow the Constitution to which you swore an oath, you're not qualified to run for office. This was set up after the U.S. Civil War. It's never been enforced before. This is the first time. But as you mentioned earlier, the Supreme Court may weigh in and may reverse this decision and allow him to continue to run in the Republican primary, which you know, puts a little more heat on Nikki Haley and Ron DeSantis. So right now, it just affects that Republican primary race, and it really doesn't have as big as an impact as you might think, except if the Supreme Court doesn't reverse it, there are going to be lawsuits all over America challenging Donald Trump's solvency. You know, as you know, he's been determined by one court to be an insurrectionist. Why not in another?
Do you think that's likely, though, Steve? What do you think that the outcome is going to
be by the
U.S. Supreme Court?
I cannot see the U.S. Supreme Court allowing this to stand. There are six conservative judges and three liberal judges on that court. They'll probably weigh in and say, hey, let the American people decide who's an insurrectionist and who's not. But, you know, I was not expecting the Colorado Supreme Court to take this decision. There have been a number of other cases in Michigan and Wisconsin and others where this was not, you know, for other reasons, this didn't go forward. So this was a surprise, but it doesn't have that much impact. I don't think we're going to see Donald Trump disqualified from the 2024 race. And this will rile up his base and his supporters and make them more even fervent Donald Trump fans.
So you're telling me MAGA supporters in their usual style aren't remaining calm and level-headed throughout this?
Well, I think they get excited when you know, the Constitution or federal government, you know, kind of intervenes or state governments intervene to tell them that their guy is not qualified to run. You have a real huge divide in the United States right now. You have people that are very much in the Donald Trump court, and a lot of other Americans that said, you know, January 6th matters. And right now, you've got Donald Trump actually out using hate speech, calling his enemies vermin. It sounds a little bit like 1930s Germany to the other side of Americans.
Steve, I have a political science degree, so I want to ask you a hard question. If you had gotten okay. Trump in the Secret Santa, what would you be getting him right now?
Oh, my God. An enemies list.
Oh, okay. Wow.
That sounds a little ominous.
Yeah,
it does.
Very scary.
It'll be long as well. Steve, 2024 is shaping up to be another wild time. Thank you very much for joining us this evening.
See you soon.